Detroit Rock City at Gord Field, where it's an absolute free-for-all.
The stakes are high, and so am I. It's in the air tonight, Grim.
This game is going to be a wholesale slaughter. No discounts in the MFL. The teams storm the field. The Tokyo Terminators take on the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's time to tune in, turn on, and drop what you're doing, because MFL Game Day is on the air. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. So what's the game plan for the home team today, Bricks?
I think they gotta keep it simple. A little cough syrup, maybe smoke a little Untidy Pod pregame so they can keep their heads in the game. I mean, literally, you don't want to get decapitated on the opening kickoff.
I say go after the refs early and often. No mercy.
Oh, with the punishing hit! Second down and five. They go to the ground game and pick up the first. Nicely done. And it's first and ten. First and ten. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and ten. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jet, you son of a bitch.
And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks.
I know, I hate those zebra men.
First and long, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. First down and forever. Oh. Second down in a mile. The nastiest dirty trick in the MFL is Chainsaw Massacre. Smiling, except this dad has a chainsaw and a turkey screaming for his life.
I like the painting of the dogs playing poker.
He did it! He scores! And with that amazing run, he burst through the end zone for six. Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. And that'll give them four more downs to punish the defense. And you better believe they will. And it's first and 10. Oh, man, I love this dirty trick. The quarterback... Great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and 10. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Second down and 7. The extra point attempt. It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10. Second down and a lot. Needs a miracle. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone!
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay!
Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
first and 10. It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
And it's first and 10. And he zings it in there for a 9-yard completion. They're moving the ball now with authority. And that'll bring up second and 1. Catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm. Team hates it.
And it's first and 10. That pass play was good for 3 yards. Second down and 7. Stepped up and blew up. He's got a lot of guts, doesn't he? And you can see the grounds crew cleaning him up now. Hot potato gets him every time. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. That's a sack.
Speaking of sacks, has anybody seen my powder? I'm itching like crazy over here.
Third down, and the QB is saying a prayer. Oh, and that's when it feels like to have removed without Novocaine. First and 10. And then Cats will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
First and 4. a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Second down and a lot. And he made a mistake there, throwing into tight. Oh, he just got crushed. First and 10. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck off. That was just a one-time thing.
That was just another day at the office for this guy. Hey, you know, he killed his boss at his old job. That's why they drafted him.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10. Left in the half. And it's first and 10. They've called us. I'm surprised no one uses the. Oh, he took a leap and had the ball knocked out. Fumble.
He's got a case of fumbleitis. It's a touchdown.
Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. And he'll pick up 7 yards on that play. And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
First down. opens up for them and allows the passing game to be more of a threat. Gotta keep. They stump the clock, but they only have one timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have mine.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. Nice run for 5 yards. The quarterback just used his final timeout. Let's see what they come up with on the next play. Second down and 5. Needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Pow! With the brain scrambler. First and 10. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
And the defense recovers the ball. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. Signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays real. Oh, big catch! Big run! Big touchdown!
Yeah, big deal. Missed a meat for brain, man, but the ball didn't fall down.
And here comes the extra point attempt. Second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? Our carnival? Huh? We're going to go to our striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. first and 10. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Well, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's first and 10. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Second down and 10. And that one's incomplete. Receiver couldn't get there.
And yeah, neither could his mother.
Third down and 10. Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. And they'll line up for the punt here. Rainbow. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. He's not going to... Boom! And it's first and 10. When defensive players go berserk, they've been known to rip the heads off of enemy players. Boom! Dead and down! He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's gonna kill you! But then he won't be able to read the message. Because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles!
The offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Hey, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
And it's first and 10. It for maybe a yard. They've got to open up the offense here, Bricks. Second down and 9. Trying to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the changes, Gord, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5. He could go all the way. Touchdown! Now, these penalties have really gotten out of hand, especially since they're fake.
Go to Dirty Tricks and hit the tag ref. It feels good.
Second down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. You gotta take bribes if you're a ref, Bricks. They get paid peanuts next to these players. It's hard to make a decent living.
Yeah, even harder when you're dead.
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. The defense is on its heels. Great run on that play. Third down and long. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10. Devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles. It was just a regular knuckles.
Oh, big catch. Big run. Big touchdown.
And big deal. Mr. Beeper Brain grabbing a ball and didn't fall down.
Mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and 10. I think the defenders are scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer!
And it's first and 10. We're tied up at the end of the third quarter. You can smell the excitement on the fans. I mean, literally, it is ripe in here. Man.
Junior, was that you?
Hey, throw me.
And that's how you run the football. First down. First and 10. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Grim, why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
You know, they're all in politics, apparently. You know what they say? Sometimes the best offense is a chainsaw full of gas. Defense must have called a hot potato dirty trick. That'll wake you up and then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose.
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. Thank you. throw. That sonic blast just cleared the field. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and 10. He's supercharged and can electrocute any opposing. Oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurdle and get hit, chances for a fumble increase. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Hey.
And here comes the extra point attempt. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Briggs. It means he can. He dies and fumbles the ball. And no one's going to his shit after the game. The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. First and 10. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Second and 3.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yowling.
And it's first and 10. Caught for the first down. And it's first and 10. The way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Second down and 5. You've got to catch that. Five. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. And the 2-minute warning sounds, they'll have to regroup during this timeout. And it's first and 10. Timeout under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. The offense just burned the defense pretty hard on that one.
That is still edible, though. Just got to scrape off the charred parts.
The timeout is called by the quarterback. They have one left. Third down and 3. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. The quarterback burns his last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore. First down and nine. And the defense holds that pass play to only 2 yards. Second down and seven. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone. How have they not killed him yet? He's wearing a new mink coat, for God's sake.
He's seven layers of smarmy, Grim.
Second down and more, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Oh, what a run there! Touchdown! No one was going to stop him. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a frog in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. And chainsaws really have a way of extending the rest of the blood. And he's off to the races. The 10.
Goal!
If you ever do that again, Bricks, I'll shoot you in the head.
Well, people like it.
Nice and easy, like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. City Maniacs lose at home.
Yeah, more like the Motor City. I can't think of a good one, Grim.
You know what? You got shit for brains.
Oh, thanks, Junior. More like the Motor City shit for brains.
They battled hard, but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chip dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chip dicks?
Yeah.
God, that was beautiful. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not.